You can start, yeah, bismillah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and thank you very much for joining us for this session. First of all, we'd like to begin by praying to Allah that may Allah accept your amal, taqabbalallahu amalakum. Last night, all the amal and the du'as, munajat, tasbih, Quran, surahs, du'as which recited, may Allah accept those things. And some of you might even have given charity, as remember we discussed that one of the things to be done on the night of Shabbat Qadr is giving charity. May Allah even accept that, inshallah. We continue our discussion from Dua Makarim Akhlaq. And subhanAllah, you will see that this particular passage is quite interesting. Man begins as usual, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa alihi. Wamna'ni min as-saraf. O Allah, prevent me from wastage. SubhanAllah, you can see wastage is such a bad habit that when a person gets into that kind of habit, Imam is saying that no, hold back, no, wamna'ani, mana'a is to prevent, just stop me from being wasteful. Wahassin riski min at-talaf. And as far as my risk is concerned, my provision is concerned, try to fortify it, from getting ruined. At-talaf is just getting ruined, for example, destroyed. And hassin is, for example, when you try to fortify or confine something in a thing. So when Allah has given you provision, don't waste it. No. Wafir malakati bil barakati fihi. No. As far as my belongings are concerned, oh Allah, bless it. No. Just bless it, because increase it through blessing. No. Increase my possessions with your blessing. So these are all indications Imam is trying to say that if you want, for example, your belongings, your estate, your wealth, your investment to bless, to increase, then pray for Allah's blessing to it, right? وَأَسِبْ بِسَبِيلِ الْهِدَايَةِ الْبِرِّ فِي مَا أَنْفِكْ, right? And then Imam says, not only that, no, set me upon the path of guidance of those people who are pious in what I spend. No, lilbir, right? We can see. So give us a guidance that when we spend, it should be also, spending should be done in such a way that through piety, right? Through righteousness. Keeping in mind that when we spend, it is through righteousness. No? That was passage 23, short passage. Then 24, we'll also get into it, because later on we have time, for example, on the 29th day, we might have time to summarize these things. So that's why next passage says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin, O Allah, bless Muhammad and his blessing and family. Waqfini ma'unat al-iktisab. No. Oh Allah, no. Just spare me the burden of earning. No. Waqfini, that means just make it enough for me. What I earn is enough for me. I should not have to toil around. No. Warzuqni min ghayri ihtisab. Not only that, subhanAllah. Allah, just give me without reckoning, without measure, without any, give me such that there is no limit to it without measure. فَلَا أَشْتَغِلَ عَنْ إِبَادِكَ بِطَلَبْ. SubhanAllah, so that I may not be distracted from your worship. Do you see one thing that which is quite interesting, which Imam is trying to say here, that we have never thought about that. When we work hard, we are trying to earn a living so as to support ourselves and family. But all this earning for family or for yourself is still a mean. The hadaf, the objective of this is what? Ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So keep this in mind, it's very important. Remember the other day I was telling you that somebody got a job, but then he was decided not to say namaz at the work and did namaz qaza. No, it should be the other way around. Our work, our schedule should all be just in such a way that we should accommodate namaz. No, we should plan our meetings, our work, around the namaz timing, because Ibadat is so important. You can see Imam says, no, lest I be distracted from your ibadat. Because وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, right? Quran clearly says, Allah says, I created human being and the jinn except for worshipping. I did not create except for worshipping. So this is important that, no, even when we work, keep in mind. So you can see Imam is giving us the reason, no? And then he says, no, وَلَا أَحْتَمِلُ إِسْرًا تَبِعَاتِ الْمَقْسَ, right? Through sticking and carry a lot of earning Israel. I should not be, no, busy just trying to all those ill results of earning. Oh, I like the translation by Mohani here, to bear the evil consequences of earning wealth by unfair means. No, so I should not, for example, bear the evil consequences of earning. That means it should not happen that, for example, just because I have to earn and support my family, I do wrong things. No, because I have to go home, my children are waiting for the food, my wife will say, where is the food? So in the process, I do something wrong. No, that should not be the case. So it is quite an interesting passage. And that's why I think this is a good passage for those facing challenges for earning. You know? Because you can see the entire, both the passages are talking about earning. And quite interesting, as I told you, is that, you know, Imam is saying that what? It should be, should not distract us from ibadat. No? So hold me back from wastage. Wastage is so bad that you have to try to make sure that you overcome the habit. Fortify provision. No? When Allah gives you something, take care of it. You know? Increase through blessing, right? No, increase your proposition through the, no, divine barakah, right? Set me on the path of guidance through piety. That means, no, as I spend, no, guide me to use the, no, path of piety, no? And also, burden of, no, spare me the burden of earning. Because, you know, earning is not an easy thing, especially as one of the hadith says that the time would come that earning, you know, one dirham halal will be more difficult than holding a charcoal in the hand. A burning charcoal in the hand is easier than to earn halal, no, earn halal living. So of course, this Imam says, no, spare me the burden of earning and provide me for without reckoning, no, without any kind of measure, lest I be distracted from your worship. So keep in mind that whenever we plan our earning, our businesses, all those things, it should be said that, no, we should not overcome as far as ibadah is concerned. Let's look at, when it comes to wastage, now, I'm not going to discuss because not my topic, but I've decided to share with you three hadiths here. Let us avoid israf totally. Let's have a zero tolerance for wastage. Now keep in mind, as we said earlier in one of the hadiths, that afatul iktisad, you know, al-bukhl. We are not trying to say that be mean, try to be, for example, be bakhil, no. But wastage should not be tolerated. So Imam says, Imam Ali says, as-sarfu masawatun wal-kastu masawatun, right? Wasting leads to stagnation of wealth, whereas thriftiness, that means economized, causes is to thrive, right? Then he says, ita'ul mali fi ghayri haqqi tabdhirun wa israfun, subhanallah. Imagine this thing. Ita'ul mali fi ghayri haqqi. When you give your wealth in a cause which is not appropriate, undeserving cause, it is squandering and wasting. Do you see this thing? So keep in mind that wastage should be avoided. Because sometimes we think that, no, because we can afford, we do asraf, a lot of things. You know, take for example, we do asraf in our clothing, we do asraf in our food, we do asraf, for example, in other things, in our dishes and whatever we like. Imagine what the hadith says. The 11th Imam of Islam says, "Inna lissakha mikdaran, fa in zada alayhi fa huwa sarfun." Imagine sakha, that means generosity itself is a very virtuous thing, right? But even in generosity, we are told that there is a limit. No, generosity is a limit, he says, and if taken to extremes, becomes asraf. Do you see? So imagine if generosity, if sakhawat can become asraf, imagine our dressing, our food, our furniture, you know, and our, for example, travel and all those things. We should be careful that, you know, let's not do asraf, because that is, and there is a whole, there are so many hadiths on asraf, but I just wanted to share with you three. So the bottom line is that let's have zero tolerance. try to avoid israf, right? You can see in sakha also you can do israf. As long as, you know, there are a number of verses in the Quran, for example, it says, "Inna Allaha yarzuku man yashau bi ghayri hisab." Now, this is the beauty of the Quran. Let me tell you one thing. If you take Quranic ayat, just read that thing. That itself is a dua, because these are divine words. So here Allah says, "Inna Allaha yarzuku man yashau bi ghayri hisab." Allah gives provision to whomsoever He wishes, without any kind of measure, you know, when He wants to give. So when somebody is suffering, read this ayat, pray to Allah, and you can see similar ayat has been repeated in Surah Al-Baqarah, this Surah Al-Imran twice, and then also Surah Al-Nur. So at least I could get four places in the Quran where Allah says, "Inna Allaha yarzuku man yasha bi hisab," or for example, sometimes it says, "Wallahu yarzuku man yasha." For example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, it says, "Wallahu yarzuku man yasha bi hisab." But the same thing, that Allah gives whomsoever wishes. So you can see that the provision is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can give you, and not only give you, but give you without hisab, without measure. You know. So of course, work hard, but at the same time, always pray to Allah to give us risk whereby we should not have the ill effects of that. So that's a beautiful passage, especially those who are suffering from, you know,